Hey YouTube, what's up? It's Sunset and Waves, and if you want to accomplish this hairstyle, please feel free to stay tuned. Girl, your hair is
And
everything. The things that you'll be needing for this tutorial, it's my first time, mind you. So the things that you'll be needing is your half wig of choice. Mine's is called the Field Soul. It's in a 427. My hair is naturally is a number 4. You're pretty much going to want to match your natural color because your real hair is going to be out in the front. So with this look, it's imperative that you match your true color, okay? At least somewhat, unless you like that two-tone look. And it's not going to look like ombre because it's not going to be like laying out nicely, okay? Now, as you can see, I have my hair in chunky twists. This was only in order to kind of stretch the natural hair without blow drying the hair. So this is why it's in these chunky twists, okay? So I have a few because I'm like a pretty much a TWA still. So like I said, the Feel Free, the Feel Soul 427, it's by Feel Free. They don't have a picture, unfortunately, of the model wearing it, but this is the brand. And it's just pretty much my half wig of choice. You can do this with straight, curly, whatever your half wig of choice is, okay? But it must be like a half wig, or you can even probably maintain the style with a front lace, okay? So this is imperative that you have this, okay? For this style, and also, you're gonna need some clips depending on the length of your hair and the amount of hair you have on your head. If you have a lot, you might need a little more. I pretty much have 4, you know, and with a TWA, it's important that you have these like duckbill clips, or some people call them alligator clips, just because you're gonna need to separate from the part, separate the hair. And because the hair is short, it's gonna wanna flop over to the other side, okay? Some grease you might want to use. The grease that I'm going to be using is the Blue Magic coconut oil. It smells yummy, yummy, yummy. And I mean, it does contain, the majority of this is petroleum jelly. However, I like it, and I'm not really into, you know, just purchasing natural products. I've been there, done that. Bought the t-shirt, and you know, my hair was its longest point when I was a little girl, and my mother, she wasn't really stressing petroleum jelly or mineral oil, so that's a whole nother video. But your grease of choice or your hair product of choice, something that's gonna lock in moisture, you know, is pretty much what you want to do. And this hair was completely washed, and I had some of this because, or you just might want to, you know, put some oil or shine. Okay, so that's what I'm using. And the Ampro Pro in Style Black Gel. This is my favorite gel. You can't even see, but I use this so much. I have a big, huge jar. Also, I just love this gel. I don't pretty prefer clear gels. I find that they flake up, and I find that they get very, very hard. And I don't find that this gets too hard. If, you know, once a little bit of water touches it, it seems to get, you know, soft again. So, and I feel that it maintains style good. So this is my staple gel. I don't use any other gel. I don't care about Eco Styler gel or any of those gels that everybody, I see Fantasia or whatever it's called. This is my gel. This is what I do. I don't do edge controls. This is what I do, okay? And it's just my stuff. This is my ski right here. So this you need. And you're gonna need some rubber bands, okay? Some little black rubber bands, all right? And you're gonna need, depending on the length of your hair, either small, if you can see, those are small bobby pins, and some large bobby pins, okay? All right. You're going to need a comb. I like to use this comb because it's wide tooth, and it also has this side, and it has to pick. You know, this is my comb of choice. I love this comb. So I'm going to get it popping right now. Hope you watch and enjoy, okay? First, you're going to take out all the twists. Taking them out. All right. Pretty much the twisted within the front region of your head, okay? So I'm taking it out, taking it out. This is my first time doing it with a laptop, and I usually do this in the mirror. So please bear with me, okay? But I pretty much take the majority of the twist out. Which, you know, like my hair is short. But you see how it's kind of stretched and there was no heat? Because I don't like to use a lot of heat. Because heat does damage your hair and your curl pattern. Now, if you're relaxed, you can also do this look. So, this is not just geared to natural hair individuals. But, you know, too much heat is not a good thing for natural hair. So, that's why I did the chunky twist. And now, I'm going to part it out. Okay? So, now... you're going to part pretty much like half of your head. Okay. This is, bear with me, it's kind of difficult. I've never done my hair like this on a computer laptop as a mirror. And I'm struggling, but I'm going to get it popping. Okay. So this is good. Now, I'm going to try to speed some of the process up so that people don't have to feel like they're being held hostage. I mean, I try to clean it up because I like a neat look. Like I said, I might be struggling a little because it's my first tutorial. But, you know, if I'm talking too much, please feel free to fast forward. Okay? I'm a Libra. I love to talk. Holla at me. All right, so... now, you see the part that I'm creating? This is a swoop part, all right? I'm going to do these medium-sized twists, okay? So, there. What? Those clips are the bomb. Stop playing. All right, so I'm combing through nicely. Now, I feel that the grease kind of prevents breakage. So, you see the little bit amount of grease I put on my finger? When it comes to gel, and it adds sheen to the part area. So I do like that, go through the hair, bomb, bomb. Okay, now I'm gonna take the gel, a little bit, same amount. Now you only need to gel one side, you don't need to get crazy. Some people like to get dab, 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 smooth down. Some people like to get crazy with the gel, but when you twist, the gel is going to distribute on the other part of their hair, okay? Get a rubber band. I know y'all don't like the whole teeth bit, but that's the only way I can maintain. So I got to do what I got to do. You're going to, don't make the rubber band too tight. You know, there's no need, this is a protective style, okay? There's no need for you to damage your hair in the process of the protective style, okay? Boom. All right. This hair, leave it out there. It's fine. We're going to deal with that later. Okay. Go to the next. Part up. Okay. I'm trying to make sure that it's straight. I'm having difficulty. Like I said, do this in the bathroom. I mean, unless you want to do it for tutorial. But baby, the glare is crazy. Nothing like a mirror. Who invented the mirror? The mirror is the bomb. All right. Your hands may be a little slippery from that grease. Okay, so, all right, now the hair is short, granted, it's curly because it's natural. Don't worry about that. I'm going to combat that also. Okay, grease. Same amount, just a dab. Okay. Getting in there. Move it down. See that piece? I love me some Earth, Wind, and Fire. Do y'all hear that? Alright. That soprano or tenor, whatever. He's singing high. That falsetto. Get it. Adele. You know, I hope you guys like the music. I try to do a mixture. Don't be in a box, ladies and gentlemen. Regardless of what your culture is, be open-minded to other music. Music doesn't know no gender or race, you know? Don't be in a box. Okay? And people don't know this Adele song, that's because y'all are late. This is Adele 19, which was her first CD, which was excellent. I was a fan from the then. You know? She deserved recognition then. Well, whatever. It took time for people to get on the bandwagon. I am mad at you. All right. Trying to keep up. I know this may be the most ghettoest hair tutorial. Because I'm in here talking about everything and anything. Alright. But that's okay. I'm just going back to the original YouTube. No intro. Just somebody sharing a little something. A little part of themselves. Okay. Nobody trying to do all that, you know, this is straight hobby. I ain't getting paid. Just doing my thing. You wanna watch, you watch. You don't, bounce. Bounce. Okay. So now the hair is curling, okay? Granted. I understand that. But you see how I can move it over? That's pretty much what some would call the baby hair. Alright. That's going to be rectified. I wouldn't even stress that. Okay. Because towards the end I'm going to fix that. Okay. But this is what we're working with. Now we're gonna make the band, okay? Now, if you are natural and you wanna stop right here, feel free to do like a bantu knot out or whatever, or twist out and let this just rock out with the twist in the front, because that could be cute too. I've definitely worn my hair like that before. So feel free to do that, okay? Rest in peace, Whitney. Can't nobody sing like Whitney. I love me some Whitney Houston. Sad what drugs will do to somebody. But her talent speaks for itself. No one, we're never gonna have this voice again. Alright. So now you're gonna take this hair. And you're gonna go. And you're going to braid across. Alright. So now, like I said, we're trying to protect the hair from the gel. That's my thinking. I don't know if it works, but that's my thinking. I'm a hairdresser. So you're going to put this on. And you want to shine and be nice. Alright. But I want to thank you. Yeah. Because you're going to put the gel on the hair, and it might start curling up a little bit, but it pretty much, I do that to make the hair all one. Then you're gonna braid. cornrow. Okay. Keep going. Braid it. Okay. You're braiding each side. What y'all know about that earth, wind, and fire? So you're braiding it down to the tip. Okay. Keep braiding to the end, okay? No stopping, alright? Don't get lazy with it, your hair. Alright, this style could last you up to 2 weeks or more. Okay, now you're gonna get another rubber band. Sorry about the teeth, excuse the teeth thing. I know y'all don't like that. I don't know why. Like, how am I supposed to open it? But whatever. And I band it all the way up. If you can see, I don't keep the banding in one motion. Because if you have like a TWA like me, this is like pretty much like holding the little short hairs that might want to come out, if you can see that. Well, you probably can't, but it kind of holds that together. You see how this banded and twisted around? Because this is going to do, okay? Now you're going to do it to this side. Now, this is not my predominant sign with my hand movement, so it's a little difficult for me, but I try to do the best I can. Great. Okay. Bigger glob. You're gonna go through the hair. Go through the hair. Okay. You're gonna do through the hair. Okay. SWV, Sisters with Voices. It's funny how people could really sing and they don't last as long as, but SWV had a good run, but they could have went longer. But you know, people try to go solo. Coco done tried to go solo by herself with Sunshine, singing that song for her son after she gave birth, and then she tried to go gospel, and now I believe SWV is back on tour. But you know, sometimes that solo thing ain't for everybody. Dawn from En Vogue went solo. She done ruined En Vogue. Then did Lucy Pearl with Tony, one of the Tonys. Raphael Sadiq. Just remembered his name. And then Lucy Pearl only had one hit, I Want to Dance Tonight. And then after that, it was a done deal. And she should have stuck to En Vogue. Then En Vogue tried to come out doing some weird stuff with just the three of them, and now they're back on tour also. So what does that teach you? Not everybody can have that Beyonce moment, right? Okay. So now I'm gonna I just took this out of the way, these clips out of the way, because I'm gonna try to get back here. Now, so you're here with two little things, okay? So now your twists are all done. The band is, the braiding, the foundation of the braiding band is done. So now what you're going to do is cross these things, okay? That's why you don't need to pull the rubber band so tight on the side, because when you cross it, you're going to feel it, baby. So don't do it too tight. And you're going to go and you're going to take a rubber band and put it around the top, all right? Now, And anyway, when you put rubber bands in your hair, you shouldn't be going tight anyway. Then you're going to loop it through. And you're going to loop the other one through. Try go from the front so that the tail end of the braid is at the back. Okay? So the band is there. Do you guys see that? Alright. The band is there. Okay? So now, with the back, you're just going to do whatever you do when you do your, when you wear your wigs to the rest of the hair. Okay? I'm not really a wig cap type of person. But, like, you can definitely rock out like this if you do a twist out and it's laying, okay, down nicely. So, you might want to spritz your hair just to make sure that it maintains some moisture so that when you comb it, it doesn't break off, okay? You go through. I'm going to go through. Put a little bit of gel. You don't really need that much. Remember, the gel is just to hold. That's why we did the gel before. It's to hold the twist. Okay? And then you can do some braids in the back. That's what I do under my wigs. Okay? So, and if your wig has a comb, the wig of your choice has a comb, do not braid it all the way back at the base, because then it's going to be tight, and when that comb goes in, it's going to break your hair off. All right, trust and believe. I don't even put the wig combs in my hair anymore because it just breaks your hair right off. All right, so I'm gonna do a big braid just to get this hair out the way, okay? And then, don't worry, like I said, we're going to clean this up, all right? And it's not going to be no toothbrush method with gel, because I left that baby hair, I leave that to TLC's Chili and the 90s, okay? But I'm going to tell you how to clean up your edges without getting that baby hair look, because I'm not really into that. The toothbrush, and then you're going to slick it to the side. Really? Like, looking like the 1994? That's not a good thing, okay? So, I put the pom-pom. You see how it's not, I didn't gather this up? This doesn't need to be stressed for the wig. It really doesn't, all right? So, you just push that, braid it, and put that pom-pom in the back. All right? All right. So, this is it. This is the last braid to go down, okay? Okay. You're going to pom-pom. Don't go all the way back. That'll snatch your hair out. When you're bald, don't come comment on my video. You're bald, you want to be bald. You don't have to do everything so tight. It doesn't have to be flush, because then you're going to stress the nape of your hair. So make these ghetto pom-poms. Don't be ashamed. You know you wanted to be a cheerleader. All right. Now, the front of your hair. Okay? This I said I would address. Your hair is natural. The baby hairs curl up. You're going to separate that. Okay? Now, you're going to take the tacky, the old part of the gel that's mostly sits, it's like kind of hardened. It mostly sits on the side of the jar, okay? Not the inside, not the wet part, not this part. You're taking the tacky part, the old part of the gel. You know why? Because I feel that that makes the hair lay down better, okay? So you're going to get the old tacky part. And you're going to get at it. You're going to sweep it to your hair. This is baby hair. When you do this and then you do some type of line, that's, we don't want to do that. You're going to sweep it up, okay? Now, if you want to do the baby hair thing, that's on you. I'm trying to tell you, leave that in the 90s. Baby hair belongs in the 90s and to Chili from TLC. Why she keep wearing that baby hair? We know you got that hair, but come on. Really? But you see how that hair is laying from the part? All right. You see how that laid? All right. Make it lay. Okay. The tacky part of the gel. You don't put your hand in it. Get the gel that's been on the jar. Okay. All right. You see, I'm holding the other twist up to get that to do a separation. You see the separation? Believe me, it really is. It's just hard to see with the camera. Okay. Okay. You're gonna come to the side. Same thing. To the hair though. You're just gathering it up. Okay, you see how that's separated? The lighting is perfect here to show what you're doing. Okay, this is separating. Okay, that's what you want. You're separating with the tacky part. Okay, this. All right, so this is not baby hair. This is just cleaning stuff up, okay? This is the tail that we tucked under. So that's how you know. You go to the front and bang, under, okay? Now, for the half-wig. Please have your eyebrows done when you rock this style. Just because they're going to be so exposed. Don't look like Bonchiqua, please. Do your eyebrows. Stop that caveman stuff. Okay? Now the only comb, when I do this, the only comb that I'm going to put in my hair, this happens to come with two combs. The only comb I'm putting in is the top, because that hair is going this way. I don't put the comb in the back because the hair is going down and that comb is going up and my hair says, oh no, don't do that to me. Okay, so you're going to break this off. Save the tags. So that you know which product you liked, you know? Don't throw them away, because then you're going to be like, wow, I had that one wig. I really liked it, but I don't know what it's called anymore, all right? So you're going to put this in the top. You want it to be flush, tight against that base, all right? And then you're going to open this up. The back, you're not going to tuck in, okay? So you're going to open this up, okay? Then you're going to take... whatever, depending on what you're comfortable with. Okay? I'm going to use the small bobby pins that I showed prior. You're going to put this in the hair. You want it to be flush. You can even put it into the base to hold it. You like it? I know you're liking it. All right? Flush. You're going to put this in. Okay? Into the base. Attach that to your head. All right, because if your wig flies off, you embarrassed all by yourself. Because if I see you, I'm laughing. You like it? You love it? All right, now you might want it. I pretty much prefer to the side. Okay. And then the back, what am I going to do? Because I didn't put those combs in, right? I'm going to get the big bobby pins. And I'm going to put that because it's smaller than a comb. I know it's going the opposite direction, but it's smaller. Okay, so it's safer. In my mindset, do what you want to do. You want to put the comb back there, do it. When your nape is bald headed, holla at me. Because I'm going to tell you, yeah, I told you so. I'm an I told you so type of person. All right, so this is in the back. You like it? You love it? I hope you do. I hope you enjoy this look. Believe me, it's set up for a whole bunch of compliments. Make sure that your half wig matches what you want. Okay, the bar should be in the front to cover. All right. Now you can rock it like this to the side, to the middle. That's cute too. All right. When the curly wigs get old, don't throw them away. Brush them in the curl pattern around your hand. I'm going to do a video on that, and that'll give it the life back. Okay.